that you all are doing well. So let's start our today's topic with a beautiful quote. So there is something beautiful in every day. You just have to find it. I mean, look at you, how gorgeous your soul is. So be positive, be happy. So today I pick up one of the confusing topic, that is atrial fibrillation and atrial flutter. So let's solve this confusion. Before moving ahead, we have one basic idea about the normal conduction system. So let's briefly summarize with this short clip. So let's see this clip. So here, electric impulse is generated from SA node, then transmitted into AV node, then bundle of His, then Purkinje fiber. Normal conduction system, but when it comes to atrial fibrillation and flutter, not only SA node but extra cardiac cell, they simultaneously generate their own impulses, so it leads to atria to contract much faster than a normal. So let's learn these two topics separately and then move on identification of these two dysrhythmia of ECG. So first, arrhythmias is a atrial fibrillation. It is one of the most common type of treated arrhythmia caused by a degeneration of electric impulses in a atria. That irregular and rapid heart rate about 100 to 175 beats per minute. So first one is a type. First type is a paroxysmal atrial fibrillation, also called occasional atrial fibrillation. You may have a symptoms that come and go, usually lasting for a few minutes to hour, and it's resolved by its own, or you may need medicine. Okay. Second type is a persistent atrial fibrillation. It is a longer than a week but less than a 1 year, so you may need medicine or treatment to stop it. Third type is a long standing persistent atrial fibrillation. It takes more than 1 year, require electric cardioversion and immediate medical attention. Fourth one is a permanent atrial fibrillation. It is called chronic or ongoing atrial fibrillation. In this, we have a difficulty to restore a normal sinus rhythm. Then causes of atrial fibrillation. Possible causes like hypertension, coronary artery disease, viral infection, hypothyroidism, sick sinus syndrome in this improper functioning of heart pacemaker, that is the SA node. Then the symptoms, some people with atrial fibrillation have no symptoms, other may experience palpitations, shortness of breath, dizziness, chest pain, fatigue and weakness. So the major concern about the atrial fibrillation is the potential to develop a blood clot within the atria that may circulate in other organ and can lead to a stroke and other dangerous condition. So main treatment goal in this arrhythmia is to control the heart rate, maintaining the normal sinus rhythm and the prevention of stroke and other complication. Doctor may give a medicine to treat the atrial fibrillation on an early phase. Okay, so this is all about the atrial fibrillation. Then the second arrhythmia is the atrial flutter. That is similar to the atrial fibrillation, but the rhythm is your atria is more organized than the atrial fibrillation, and the heart rate is faster, around 200 to 300 beats per minute. So types. First type is a paroxysmal atrial flutter. It also called occasional atrial flutter. You may have symptoms that come and go, and usually lasting for a few hours to a day. Okay. Second type is a persistent atrial fibrillation, which require medical attention and medical treatment. Then causes of atrial flutter. Possible causes are coronary artery disease, then COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, then hypertension, then cardiomyopathy, open heart surgery. Then the symptoms of atrial flutter is heart palpitation, shortness of breath and syncope, or we can say dizziness. Okay, this is about atrial flutter. So this both condition are similar to each other and have a some differentiation in a characteristics, like atrial fibrillation have a irregular rhythm and atrial flutter have a regular rhythm. Okay, so let's identify the atrial fibrillation and atrial flutter on a ECG. So we have understand via short clip. Okay, so let's see this clip.
Video, you can saw that how atrial fibrillation look like on ECG. There is a regularly irregular rhythm. It means differentiation of RR interval, and we cannot definitely identify the P wave on this ECG. So this how ECG look like on atrial fibrillation.
So here in atrial fibrillation, you can see that we cannot identify the P wave. There is a absence of isoelectrical baseline and also irregular RR interval in a atrial fibrillation ECG. Then next one is a atrial flutter ECG. So let's see.
You can see the atrial flutter on a ECG. Atrial flutter result from an abnormal electrical signals inside the upper chamber of a heart, that is the atria. It beats extra fast, about 250 to 400 beats per minute. As you can see, the main characteristic of atrial flutter is a sawtooth wave, and it is a usually regular rhythm instead of atrial fibrillations, which have a regularly irregular rhythm. The atrial flutter have a usually regular rhythm and sawtooth wave shaped like.
Here you can see the atrial flutter on a ECG. The main characteristic is a sawtooth wave shape like flutter wave in this ECG, and here we also lost the isoelectrical baseline, and here the regular RR interval is present. The wave is like sawtooth wave. Here you can see in second image. So I hope that you all are understand the differentiation between atrial fibrillation and flutter. So let's see this strip and guess the dysrhythmia showing in this strip. So here we can identify in this ECG strip, you can identify the irregular RR interval, then absence of P wave and the absence of isoelectrical baseline. So this is a ECG strip of atrial fibrillation. Then the next strip, so here we can see the sawtooth wave and flutter wave and regular RR interval. So this is atrial flutter. So here we identify the both ECG. We finish the both identification of dysrhythmia on ECG. I hope that you are able to differentiate this both dysrhythmias. Thank you. Thank you for watching. And if you have any query, then let me know on comment box. Thank you.